Well, this morning, I think that everyone who has ever read Psalm 83 and questioned Psalm 83 is asking the question, has the Psalm 83 war started? Which just happens to be the title of our message today. Has the Psalm 83 war started? Now, as we all know, last Saturday, a week ago, we began hearing about the Hamas terrorist group infiltrating the borders of Israel. As of Friday morning, as I was preparing this message, there have been more than 2,800 deaths, over 5,300 injured due to this barbaric act of violence from the Hamas terrorist group. 13 of these brutal deaths were innocent Jewish men, women, and children. Today, since everybody's asking that question, we're going to take a deep dive into this question, all right? And see what the Word of God says. But for those who are watching online, or anyone that may be here this morning that hasn't heard about that, I'm going to do a really quick overview of what Psalm 83 is. Just a quick one. This prophecy of a coming war was written by Asaph. Asaph was one of King David's three chief musicians. He was considered to be a seer. And you can read all about that in 2 Chronicles 29 and 30 if you want to read that. So what is a seer? A seer is a prophet who sees visions. They see what God is doing and revealing to them rather than just hearing the word. So a seer is a prophet, but all prophets are not necessarily seers. So what Asaph was writing here in Psalm 83 is what God was showing him at that time and what was going to happen at some point in the future. Asaph lived 3,000 years ago. Been a day or three. 3,000 years ago. So if you'd all like to stand, I don't have to tell you what our text is this morning. Psalm 83, of course. It says, NLT, and we're going to be using the NLT all day today. It says, O God, do not be silent. Do not be deaf. Do not be quiet. O God, don't you hear the uproar of your enemies? Don't you see that your arrogant enemies are rising up? They devise crafty schemes against your people. They conspire against your precious ones. Come, they say, let us wipe out Israel as a nation. We will destroy the very memory of its existence. Yes, this was their unanimous decision. They signed a treaty as allies against you. These Edomites, Ishmaelites, Moabites, Hagrites, Gerbilites, Ammonites, Amalekites, and the people of Philistia.